The Boeing FA-18E and FA-18F Super Hornet are twin-engine, carrier-capable, multi-role fighter aircraft variants based on the McDonnell Douglas FA-18 Hornet. The FA-18E single-seat and FA-18F tandem-seat variants are larger and more advanced derivatives of the FA-18C and D Hornet. The Super Hornet has an internal 20mm M61 rotary cannon and can carry air-to-air missiles and air-to-surface weapons. Additional fuel can be carried in up to 5 external fuel tanks, and the aircraft can be configured as an airborne tanker by adding an external air refueling system. Designed and initially produced by McDonnell Douglas, the Super Hornet first flew in 1995. Low-rate production began in early 1997, with full-rate production starting in September 1997, after the merger of McDonnell Douglas and Boeing the previous month. The Super Hornet entered fleet service with the United States Navy in 1999, replacing the Grumman F-14 Tomcat, which was retired in 2006. The Super Hornet serves alongside the original Hornet. The Super Hornet entered fleet service with the U.S. Navy in 1999. It achieved initial operating capability in September 2001 with the U.S. Navy's Strike Fighter Squadron 115 at Naval Air Station Lemoore, California. As of October 2008, Boeing had delivered 367 Super Hornets to the U.S. Navy. On April 6, 2009, Defense Secretary Gates announced that the Department of Defense intended to acquire 31 FA-18s in FY 2010. Congress requested the DoD study a further multi-year contract so that a projected fighter shortfall could be averted. In 2006, the Navy was 60 fighters below its validated aircraft requirement. The FY 2010 budget bill authorized a multi-year purchase agreement for additional Super Hornets. A multi-year contract was finalized on September 28, 2010, reported as saving $600 million over individual yearly contracts, for 66 Super Hornets and 58 Growlers to mitigate a four-year delay in the F-35 program. On August 7, 2014, U.S. defense officials announced they had been authorized to launch bombing missions upon ISIS forces in northern Iraq. The decision to take direct action was made to protect U.S. personnel in the city of Erbil and to ensure the safety of transport aircraft making airdrops to Yazidi civilians. Early on August 8, two Super Hornets took off from the George H.W. Bush and dropped 500-pound laser-guided bombs on a mobile artillery piece the militants had been using to shell Kurdish forces defending the city. On June 18, 2017, U.S. Navy FA-18E shot down a Syrian Air Force Su-22 fighter bomber that allegedly had bombed a position held by U.S.-supported Syrian Democratic Forces near Tabqa. The Syrian government claimed the Su-22 was bombing an ISIS position. This was the first aerial kill of a manned aircraft by an American fighter since 1999, the first kill by a Super Hornet, and the third kill by an FA-18. An E-3 sentry issued several warnings to the Su-22 and, after it dropped bombs near SDF fighters, the FA-18E, piloted by Lieutenant Commander Michael Mobdremel, a pilot assigned to Strike Fighter Squadron 87 aboard the carrier George H.W. Bush, independently chose to shoot it down based on established rules of engagement. The FA-18E first missed with an AIM-9X Sidewinder, then hit the Su-22 with an AIM-120M ROM. The encounter lasted 8 minutes. In 2018, Boeing was awarded a contract to convert 9 single-seat FA-18E Super Hornets and 2 FA-18F two-seaters for Blue Angels use. These are due for completion by 2021.
Hawkins, we just got raised to Alert 1. Plans have changed. We're launching now. CAG says we're special today. We're not on station for some Whiskey Delta ground support. DASC is going to fill us in airborne, but we are flying a strike mission over Tehran into Mehrabad Airport. ELINT has sat images. They think they know where al-Bashir is. So, get your fangs out, Hawkins. We're hunting big game today. That's pretty much it. There's Iranian bogeys in the air already. Pucker factor, 9.7. Farouk al-Bashir is about to have a really bad day. Okay, let's rock and roll.
Shark 4-6, there are aircraft coming out of the Hardin bunkers. They're trying to take off. Over.
4-6, roger. Hawkins, reference those three bunkers across from the main terminal. Use infrared and laser them for Striker 2-2. That's it.
Reaper 1, you got another fighter turning onto the runway now.
Good kill. That's the last one.
This is Reaper 1. I've three vehicles moving along the runway. This might be our HPT. Wait out.
Shark 4-6, stand by to engage if the target is verified.
How? Copy.
Roger. Okay, Hawkins. Get ready to laser for Bulldog 3-3.
Reaper 1, Heavy 212. Be advised, you have a single aircraft approaching from the south at low speed, altitude 502. Do you have eyes on? Over.
Roger. It's a helicopter. Looks like it's headed for the vehicles.
Roger. You have 4-6 on station.
4-6, this is Reaper 1. We need them to get out of the car so we can verify it's our target. Stand by to engage.
Bulldog 3-3. We will laze for Gunron. How copy?
Roger. Solid copy. Coming around now.
They're definitely PLR. You are clear to engage. You are clear to engage.
Paint the area. 3-3 is standing by.
We have individuals running. You are clear to take them out too.
Roger.
Roger. 3 seconds.
Signs be advised. We have friendly units securing the airbase now. Negative, I'm for the ground attack. How copy?
Roger. Solid copy. Switch off the camera. Let's get back to the bump. Heavy 212. Shark 4-6 egressing out of target area.
Roger. Turn to heading 040. Watch for traffic with feeder wet. 212 out.
Approaching glide path, slightly out. Course correcting at 3 miles. Shark 4-6, 2 miles out.
Hook down!
Shark 4-6, got your hook down, looking good, you got the ball. Shark 4-6, on glide path, on course. Put him on, call the ball.
I got the ball, bringing her down.
40 knots, on the ball.